we're starting to click as far as health, as far as everyone's game, you know, coming together at the right time.
For all the drama that surrounds the Lakers, Lamar Odom brings a steadiness and versatility that the team has come to depend on.
You know, you're really talking about a guy who I think makes this team the perennial championship contender that it is.
Lamar Odom is off to a sensational start this year.
He's been the most consistent Laker throughout the year. He shoots 60% from the field. He plays four different positions. If you ask Phil Jackson or Kobe Bryant, they'll tell you Lamar Odom should be on the All-Star team.
Lamar's the player that a lot of people don't understand. They look at the TV and they see this guy who's angular, tall player, but nothing stands out. But when you're down at court level and you see this guy who's 6'10", handling the ball, driving by guys, guards and big men.
The drive, the slam, show! Lamar Odom!
And you realize that the other team has to put somebody out there on the floor to try and deal with it.
Odom goes behind the back! Are you kidding me?
Whether it's 5 points and 10 rebounds or, you know, 25 points and 15 rebounds, everything counts.
Lamar's got 17 boards in 26 minutes.
But talent aside, it's his team-first attitude that makes Odom such a perfect fit.
His temperament and the fact that he's been able to sacrifice so much of his own statistics for the betterment of the team, I don't think is talked about enough. You know, case in point this year, Lamar had to start the season for Andrew Bynum, and then he goes right back to the bench, doesn't say a word about it. And that's why Lamar is so beloved in that locker room.
Everybody loves Lamar. Just because of that, he's not a selfish player. He just plays hard. He just does the things that we need in order to win.